Assalamu alaikum. How are you, my dear students in grade 6? Welcome back with Mr. Muad JB. Today we'll be discussing lesson 3 for absolute value. Today, by the end of the lesson, inshallah, students will be able to interpret absolute value in mathematical and real world situations. Let me start. What I mean by absolute value? Here, I will show you an example. The absolute value of a number is its distance from zero on the number line. So distance is always positive. So even if the number is negative, the distance from zero will be positive. So 5 and negative 5 have the same distance from zero. So they have the same absolute value. So they have the same absolute value, which is 5. So the absolute value of 5 is written as 2 bars and 5 in the middle. The absolute value of negative 5 is written as 2 bars and negative 5 in the middle. So the absolute value of 5 and the absolute value of negative 5, both of them equals 5. So two opposite numbers have the same absolute value because absolute value represents distance from 0, which is always positive. Now, to find 2 years with the greatest change, use absolute value. Now, of course, I'm talking about this example. Here, negative numbers sometimes repeat represent debts. The table shows 3 account balances that represent debts, till which account balance is the least number. Then use absolute value to find which account represent the greatest debt. As you can see, we have 3 accounts A, B, C. This has a balance negative 35, this negative 50, and this one is negative 12. Now, the first part of the question, till which account balance is the least number? The least number is the greatest absolute value. On a number line, negative 50 is further from 0 than either 35, negative, or negative 12. So negative 50 is the least number because the negative 50 is the furthest number from 0. So always the negative numbers, when we have a lot of some negative numbers, the one is the least, which has the greatest value. The greatest value. So the money owed is the absolute value of each balance. Now, the absolute value of negative 35, 35, negative 50 is 50, and the absolute value, we read these two bars as absolute value if negative 12 equals 12. So 50 is the greatest amount of money owed. So account B represents the greatest debt. So this guy or this account has the greatest, debt because it's the least value. Here we are. Now, explain why negative 7 has a greater absolute value than the absolute value of 6. Because the absolute value of 6 is 6, and the absolute value of negative 7 is 7. Now, find each absolute value. The absolute value of negative 9 is 9. Whether the number is negative or positive, the absolute value will be equals positive. The absolute value of 5, 3 over 4, he doesn't ask me about the opposite. He asked me about what? The absolute value, so I should write it as positive. Here, the absolute value of negative 5.5 is 5.5. Now, we need to use less than, greater than, or equal to compare. Here, absolute value of negative 19 is 19. Absolute value of negative 11. I'm not comparing negative 11 and negative 19. I'm comparing their absolute value. So the absolute value of negative 19 is greater than the absolute value of negative 11. And here we are. The absolute value of 2.5 negative is equal to positive 2.5. And the absolute value of 2.5 is 2.5. So they are equal. By this, we come to the end of our video. Thank you very much. If you like the video, press like and don't forget to subscribe my channel and turn on notifications. Thank you.